and Will Fisher Distributing, by Dennis Hank Chevrolet, and by the Jim Stafford.
And this is that madhouse known as the Hammond Student Center on the campus of Southwest Missouri State University, home of the Bears and Lady Bears, and setting for tonight's very big basketball game. And we bid you good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Lady Bears on KY3. I'm Ned Reynolds. It is a great honor to have you with us on this Thursday evening. The Lady Bears face a huge test tonight. A much-improved Creighton team is here to challenge SNS, which is in a challenge of its own right for first place in the Missouri Valley. Oh, yeah, Tom Mass, there's something else going on tonight.
Oh, really? Yeah, the greatest export out of the state of Kansas since Dorothy is front and center tonight. Jackie Stiles wrapping up 4 years of outstanding play, gunning for that NCAA record.
Let's check the keys to tonight's game, brought to you by Copy Products, your digital copier specialist.
Ned, I'll tell you what, the Creighton Lady Jays tonight, they've got to try to take that game to the post this evening, make things happen down low. They've got to try to overcome this crowd of 9,000. For the Lady Bears, their defense has been shaky lately. They need to find a little, and oh yes, they need to remember they're playing for more than that record.
This is an extremely big basketball game. It could produce one of the most significant moments in Ozark sports history. You're in the right place to see it all as the Lady Bears take on Creighton.
Hello.
Come home early.
I'm working.
I lit some candles.
I'm swamped.
I bought my flies.
Oh! Oh! For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Come again.
Yeah, he's got a pencil, Lazarus.
Now what? The storm is over. Now what? The blueprints are complete. Now what? The broken water pipe is fixed. Now what? Fire. Storms, remodeling projects, or flooding. Call Kimco Construction and get the job done right. As owner Hal Grissom says, put your job on our backs. Kimco Construction is a proud member of the Home Builders Association. Call Kimco at 881-8147 today.
It's where you send a friend, Dennis Hanks in Ozark, where folks come back again.
Just about planning. It's about living. It's about offices nearby, where long-term relationships outweigh short-term gains. At Edward Jones, it's never just about investing. It's about knowing you and your dreams.
My every hope, my life, my world, it all begins with a dream.
Edward Jones, investing in you and your dreams.
Hi, folks. Jim Stafford here. Looking for something a little different? Just trying to drum up a little business.
Ned Reynolds along with Tom Mass, and great to have you with us. Lady Bears basketball on KY3. Tonight's starting lineup is a presentation of PennMac. PennMac personnel, we place people first. Tom Mass.
Lady Jays from Creighton, led by the seniors, Christy Spanheimer and Angela Timmons. They'll get support there. And for your Lady Bears, it's the trio of Deer, Mitchum, and Stiles on the senior side.
The Creighton ball club is coached by Connie Urey, who is in her ninth year at Creighton and has played against some of the great scorers in college basketball history, Lori Ballman, Cheryl Miller, Lynette Woodard, among others. And, of course, the Lady coached by the venerable Cheryl Burnett, 294 and 122 in her 14th year as the coach of Southwest Missouri State. We're set to start it off. It'll be Erica Hunte, who does the leaping for the Lady Bears, and Kim Hover does the jumping for Creighton, and out of the scrum, Jackie Stiles picks up the loose ball, and we're underway at the Hammond Student Center, Southwest Missouri State in Creighton. Very big game for the Lady Bears, who are in second place in the Missouri Valley Conference. That's Stiles. Dennis. He is now 2 points closer. Needs 18 to break that national record, and the Lady Bears are up 2-0. Angela Timmons with the ball for Creighton. Oh, a great pass underneath, but the Lady Jays can't finish. Ball goes off the hands of Creighton's Christy Neneman, and it will be Southwest Missouri State's ball. Huge throng on hand, Tom.
You cannot squeeze another person in this building, and every time Stiles lights it up tonight, you're going to hear all 9,000 plus.
That's Melody Campbell with the ball for SMS, and Jackie at the top of the key. And Jackie is being chased by two players. Now one of them falls off. This is Carly Beer. And the Lady Bears off to what they wanted, a quick start against this very good Creighton team. SMS 4, Creighton nothing. Angela Timmons brings it down for Creighton, which is 17-8 on the year and riding the crest of a five-game winning streak. Circus shot thrown up by Christine Neneman doesn't go, and the Lady Bears are breaking. This is Campbell. Uh-oh, and Melody Campbell traveled as she made the pass to Erica Hante. Melody Campbell took too many steps.
I think she was thinking left to Stiles, and then she saw Hante open up, and a little stutter step in there cost her.
So Creighton gets the ball on the turnover, and this is Angela Timmons, who will bring it down over the midcourt line against the guarding of Melody Campbell, one of the five seniors on this club. That's Timmons. Oh, wild shot. Lady Bears are breaking.
It's almost a faster pace than the Lady Bears want to play at, man.
Tara Mitchum on the left wing has the ball, coming off an ankle injury suffered in the Wichita State game. This is Campbell into the paint. And Erica Hante up for the rebound and may have committed a foul. That's to whom they charged the foul, Erica Hante. The fouled party for the Creighton Ball Club is Sarah Hildebrand, and here comes Creighton down court. A quick pass underneath is knocked out of the hands of Christy Neneman, who had posted up underneath. It will be the Lady Bears basketball. We're in the very early minutes of the first half at the Hammond Student Center, SMS and Creighton. Free for the jump shot and burying it is Christy Neneman, and it is a 4-2 ball game as Creighton suddenly has had the Lady Bears lead. This is Hante on the post, double teamed, almost lost the ball. Picked up there by Tara Mitchum. Good move by Tara. Carly Deer with a quick swing pass into Mitchum, and she traveled in the lane. Tara Mitchum caught the pass cleanly, but took too many steps in the paint, and another turnover for SMS. Lady Bears will be back in action 48 hours from now, meeting Drake, which is currently in first place in the Missouri Valley Conference. That'll be Saturday afternoon. This is Neneman, knocks over a Lady Bear, and that's a charging foul on Christy Neneman.
A little bit out of control. Deer held her ground. Watch it right here. Takes the lane. Deer stays with her all the way. Gets that good position, draws the charge.
This Neneman is a good-looking 5'10 freshman from Omaha. She's a hometown kid and promises a great future with the Creighton Ball Club. There's Jackie Stiles. She'll take the shot. Jackie is 16 points away from the national record, and the Lady Bears are up 6-2. Angela Timmons on the right wing. This is Timmons into the lane. Now backs it out to Chrissy Spanheimer. Chrissy will take the shot. Bounces off the front of the rim. Rebound goes to Creighton, but right into the hands of Tara Mitchum, and here come the Lady Bears on a break. That's Melody Campbell underneath to Mitchum again, and Tara Mitchum commits an offensive foul. Tara Mitchum, the Springfield Glendale product and a transfer from Ohio State University in her final year with the Lady Bears, commits the offensive foul.
Tried to move to her left. Good position by Timmons there. Draws it. That's two fouls on the Lady Bears.
Now we make a substitution. The Creighton team does as Tanya Senek comes into the contest. Ms. Senek is wearing number 13, and she will bring the ball over the midcourt line. Tanya's from Hot Springs, Arkansas. That's Timmons, top of the key. Very good player, all conference. Angela Timmons, and she drives it home. They are Angela's first two of the night, and it's a 6-4 ball game. The Lady Bears maintaining the lead by two. This is Campbell. Stiles, top of the key. Long shot, Jackie. Doesn't go. Rebound is pulled off by the Lady Bears, and Erica Hunter puts it back in.
Great awareness by Mitchum there. She knew she was in trouble, saw the open player, and gave it away.
And the post players, who have been much maligned for the Lady Bears in recent weeks, are coming to the fore, Tom.
Well, they've got to, Ned. In the last couple of weeks, like you say, they've had trouble.
Tara Mitchum gets the rebound off the wild shot by Tanya Sinek. This is Campbell up court. Great pass underneath, and Erica Hunte has two more.
Quick timeout.
And the timeout is taken by Connie Urey of the Creighton Blue Jays. She doesn't want this to get too terribly out of hand. It's 10-4. The Lady Bears have the lead. Timeout signaled to the Creighton Ball Club. And we will take a timeout here. You're watching the Lady Bears and Creighton, with the Lady Bears holding a 10-4 lead.
Spring's on the way, and so is March Madness. So to keep you going, Mrs. O'Mealy's will give you a choice. You can enjoy a complete chopped beef steak or a chicken fried steak with mashed potatoes and gravy, corn or green beans, roll with butter, fruit cobbler or chocolate cake, and coffee or tea, all for only $5.99, a regular $8.15 value. Now through March 31st at Mrs. O'Mealy's on Sunshine, just east of Bass Pro.
I'm Dr. Norman Gary, and I'm a bee expert. All right, bee.
Dr. Norman Gary will do some pretty outrageous things.
I've been stung probably around 75,000 times.
But would Norm Gary ever get car insurance that didn't come with a State Farm agent?
Car insurance with no State Farm agent? Now that makes me nervous.
For car insurance, be like this State Farm customer. And get an agent you can rely on.
You got six legs, use them, baby.
Plus competitive rates.
Is your career stuck in the pit? Then put the PennMac Career Team to work for you. Rev up your career with PennMac's free classes, including GED, computer tutorials, and even English as a second language. Then put your career into high gear with PennMac's hands-on training in some of today's most in-demand jobs. Call the PennMac team and start your race to the top now. PennMac Personnel Services, 831-6888.
We are delighted that you're with us on this Thursday evening. The Lady Bears in Creighton and Southwest Missouri State has a 10-4 lead. Tom asked the 4 points from Jackie Stiles. You'd expect the 4 points from Erica Hunte. You would not expect.
Those are good points for Shelburne's ball club. As we mentioned at the outset, the inside game, they've been very weak recently, and they need to pick up production there.
SMS defense has created some havoc with the Creighton ball club, which was beaten by the Lady Bears 84-59 back in December up in Omaha. Nice move into the paint by Teresa Wessling. The ball does not fall, however, and here come the Lady Bears breaking. Jackie gets the pass from her roommate, Carly Deer. Stiles into the paint. May have forced the shot, and Creighton comes up with a rebound. It's Chrissy Spanheimer who pulled it down. This is Spanheimer into the paint.
Oh, yeah.
A whistle and an offensive foul is charged to Chrissy Spanheimer.
Committed the ultimate sin, Ned. She lowered the shoulder going to the basket. You're going to see it right here. Good toss across. Good fake right. Comes in and watch her right shoulder. See that?
That constitutes a charging foul, and that is the call against Chrissy Spanheimer of the Creighton Lady Jays, who have now committed their second team foul. Jackie's pass is deflected, picked off by Erica Hunte, who scores. A fortuitous bounce to Erica Hunte, and she has 6 points to lead the Lady Bears in scoring.
Good strip.
Here's a steal. This is Melody Campbell. And she is fouled on the play, and Melody Campbell will go to the line. Erica Hunte has already bettered her season's average. At 4.4 points a game, Erica Hunte already has six.
Watch this steal. What a fleece right here by Campbell. Actually, a turnover by Timmons, and Campbell is there. And Campbell's going to pay the price at the other end. Big hit on the wrist there. She'll shoot a pair.
Melody hasn't been to the line very often this year, only 20 times, and connected on 7 occasions. She is only a 35% free throw shooter. Head coach Cheryl Burnett looking on. along with her assistant Karen Rapier. Second shot, Melody Campbell. This one is good. And it's a 13-4 lead for Southwest Missouri State. Angela Timmons controlling the club out of the point guard position. Timmons almost lost the ball. Double team. Long bomb from outside, way off the mark, but the rebound is pulled down by Jenny Burns. This is Burns in trouble, gets the ball back to Timmons, 19 seconds on the shot clock. Now Angela Timmons being guarded by Jackie Stiles. Angela will shoot.
That brought rain.
Carly Deer with a rebound, and the Lady Bears, sensing that perhaps they have the Creighton team on the run, get it up court. Great pass underneath to Hunte, and she is fouled on the play. Erica Hunte, who is every bit of 6'4", is emerging as a power underneath, and she's almost pounded that one home.
Ned, it's the passing by the teammates. They are setting each other up so well with great bounce passes, good looks, and Hunte within a couple of inches of really completing a nice one there.
51% free throw shooter is Erica Hunte, who is from Sao Paulo, Brazil, has 7 points in the early going. 14-4, Lady Bears up by 10. Second shot for the transfer from Bacone Junior College down in Oklahoma. And if you would have guessed at this point that Erica Hunte would be leading the Lady Bears in scoring, well, they would have guarded you off. 15-4, the Lady Bears have the lead. This is Timmons to the goal. Oh, nice move by Angela Timmons. That's her fourth, third, and fourth points of the night, and 15-6, and the Creighton Lady Jays have broken a drought. This is Melody Campbell. Rebound pulled down by Kim Hover, and here comes Creighton. The Creighton men's team is the regular season champions of the Missouri Valley Conference and the top seed for the Valley Tournament coming up this weekend in St. Louis.
Oh.
Nice rebound pulled down by Kim Hover. And Angela Timmons caught it. Referee Lou Pitt says, yeah, I'm afraid you took too many steps, and Angela Timmons pleasantly disputes the call. We have 12:47 remaining in the first half in Springfield, Missouri. It's SMS 15 and Creighton 6.
Erica Vicente comes in, Ned, and if you think the pace has been quick to this point, wait till you see when she brings the ball down the floor.
Vicente is replacing Melody Campbell. This will be Jackie Stiles being guarded by Chrissy Spanheimer. These two have battled head-to-head for the last 4 years. Tara Mitchum on the right wing. Now finds Erica Vicente. This is Mitchum, top of the key. Vicente into the paint. 17-6. Lady Bears have the lead, and everything is falling, and now we have a whistle. Oh, no whistle at all. It's a turnover. There's Jackie, coast to coast. And she is hammered, and Jackie Stiles may have gotten shaken up.
She hit her head, Ned. That is not a way to endear yourself to 9,000 fans.
She's okay. Jackie is tough.
This is a foul. That was a good block of the ball, Ned. That really was.
Jackie Stiles goes to the line for two shots. And for the year, she is an 88% free throw shooter. Creighton is Donya Finch, who committed that foul on Jackie Stiles. That is 6 points for Jackie, and a 19-6 lead for the Lady Bears. Here's a three-point bomb from outside taken by Christine Enneman. It does not go, and here comes SMS. Vicente to Mitchum, to Carly Deer, and now to Hunte.
Ned, they're winning the war inside.
And timeout is called by Clayton as Coach Connie Urie calls for a 30-second timeout. 11:43 remaining in the first half, 21-6. Lady Bears have the lead.
I do my very best to take care of my family and my home. That's why I'm replacing all our windows with new energy-efficient Marvin windows. They're easy to install, and Springfield Mill and Lumber has a great selection. I'm sure they'll reduce my heating and cooling costs and save us money so we can do other things, like put in new Marvin doors. I feel much better knowing that my family is snug as a bug with Marvin windows from Springfield Mill and Lumber, 216 West Central.
I'll be right out. Let me just put this Bud Light away.
Hey, Otto. Come on.
Honey, where's Otto? Otto? Otto?
With a great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
This Rolex is the perfect combination of delicacy and strength. You can see it today at Maxim's. From the oyster case to the more than 200-piece movement, every element must meet the most exacting standards before the timepiece can wear the Rolex crown. This remarkable watch took an entire year to create. Time well spent. To see a selection of Rolex timepieces, visit Maxim's, your official Rolex jeweler.
While Jackie Stiles is the people's choice in Springfield, Missouri, Eric Ahante has said, what's this about a scoring record? Give me the basketball.
Well, I'll tell you what great ball movement right here. Look at Carly Deere, not afraid to kick it inside. And Ahante, when she shakes the defender, Ned, untouched, 10 points.
Eric Ahante, leading all scorers in this game, does have 10. She is number 40, junior college transfer from Pacon Junior College in Oklahoma, hometown Sao Paulo, Brazil. It is 21-6. The Lady Bears have the lead. Now it's time to take a look at the Missouri Valley Conference standing, brought to you by Edward Jones. Tom, real quickly.
Well, it's a Drake SMS war, both playing tonight. Lady Bears have got to remember they got to get past this one before setting up that big showdown on Saturday afternoon. Drake at Wichita this evening, by the way.
Edward Jones with more than 125 years of experience helping individuals build financial security. Very happy to bring you the Missouri Valley Conference standings as Connie Urie, the nine-year veteran coach at Creighton, looks on. They're mopping up some moisture on the floor. Now we should be set to go. Lady Bears 21, Creighton 6. There is Cheryl Burnett. Now they still have some more polishing to do down in the paint here at the Hammond Student Center.
I looked over late. I thought he was getting shoe shine.
It almost looked like a shoe shine, didn't it? That's Lou Pitt, the veteran referee. And now we are set to go, and Creighton will have possession. Boy, the points in the paint are very significant.
Well, we're going to pat ourselves on the back all night long because of our pregame predictions. The inside game going to be a big decisive part of the outcome tonight.
Erica Hunte with 10 points getting extended playing time. Angela Timmons, she bombs one home. That's a two for Angela, who has 6 points for Creighton, and it's 21-8. Favor SMS. This is Vicente down court. Now the Lady Bears work it around the perimeter. Jackie trying to work off a screen. Well, the pass from Erica Vicente a little bit too long and a turnover, and now Southwest Missouri State will make some more substitutions, but not before we take a timeout here at the Hammond Student Center.
Hi, Roger here from Race Brothers. You got to mow the lawn, so you might as well do it with a white LT1600 mower. These affordable units come with plenty of old-fashioned, honest-to-goodness work ethic. When you're looking for muscle, you get more with White Outdoor. White Outdoor equipment gets the job done, from small yards to taking care of larger areas of land. Come on out to Race Brothers, 2310 West Kearney in Springfield, or Race Brothers in Carthage. You'll like the way we do business. Tell a friend.
Hi, this is Dolly. You ever wonder why I personally guarantee that my Dixie Stampede is the most fun place to eat? Well, won't you see for yourself?
Dixie Stampede.
feast. Come visit my Dixie Stampede dinner and show. It's the most fun place to eat in Branson. I guarantee it.
March does crazy things to a guy. You get hoops on your mind, and all you can think about is making a fast break to Colony Home Theater and Lifestyles for the Mitsubishi Big Screen Hoop Stakes. Enter to win over $250,000 in prizes, including an ultimate Mitsubishi home theater system. Plus, buy any Mitsubishi Big Screen and pay absolutely nothing till January 2002. The Mitsubishi Big Screen Hoop Stakes. Now till the end of March, Colony Home Theater and Lifestyles in Brentwood Center South.
We welcome you back to the Hammond Student Center in Springfield, Missouri. Southwest Missouri State meeting Creighton tonight, and the Lady Bears of SMS, as you can see, have a 21-8 lead as Angela Timmons puts the ball in play for Creighton. Timmons being guarded by Melody Campbell. Look at the field goal numbers there, Tom. The Lady Bears shooting lights out. Loose ball, the battle for it, and Melody Campbell comes up with it. That battles Angela Timmons. Now Ann Cavey comes in to play the post for Southwest Missouri State, and a whistle stops the action, and we have one of the Blue Jays injured down here at our end of the court.
Can't see who it is just yet, Ned. I think looks like an ankle, the way she's lifting that. Can I see the number? I'm sorry, I can't tell who it is just yet. But she's in some obvious pain. Oh, I
believe it's Kim Hover.
It is Hover, yeah, a starter.
And she quite obviously has been shaken up. We'll see what the nature of her injury is. It is either an ankle or a knee, but Kim is really not feeling very well at all. And there is Coach Connie Urey visiting with her.
I think they're signaling they're going to need some additional assistance out there. She's a junior out of Bonner Springs, as you see there. And, Ned, honestly, I don't think anybody has any idea what the nature of where it happened, because the ball was so far away from where she's at.
We'll check back on our footage here to see if we have just exactly what happened to Kim. Here's the play right here.
Number 40. Watch number 40 closely.
There she is in the paint posting up.
Oh, like, do you see the left knee buckle?
Yeah, it's apparently a knee injury. And she evidently already had some problems with the knee anyway. She has a cumbersome brace on there, and that's what it is. And that's Kim Hover being helped off now for Creighton.
And her reaction on the floor, you could tell either she'd been through it before or she knew instantly that she had a major problem.
Well, that's too bad. As number 40 is helped off the court, that's Kim Hover from Bonner Springs, Kansas. Now action resumes as Tanya Sinek comes back in for Creighton. 21-8, the SMS Lady Bears have the lead. This is Sinek being guarded by Melody Campbell. This jump shot is taken. It did not go. That was Teresa Wessling who got it, but the putback by Creighton. And that is Christy Neneman who put it back in, and it is 21-10, favor SMS. Underneath is Tara Mitchum, who misses the crip shot. Ball goes out of bounds, and possession will go to Creighton.
She got a little too deep under the basket there and just couldn't finish.
Tanya Sinek will bring the ball over the midcourt line with Melody Campbell putting on the pressure. We're about to approach the halfway mark of the first half, and SMS has the 21-10 lead. Jackie Stiles with 6 points. A little turnaround jump shot by Wessling does not go, and the Lady Bears have the rebound. SMS, an up-tempo basketball team. Melody Campbell. There's Jackie on the left wing. Good reverse pass to Deer. Now underneath the Cavey, and Ann Cavey is fouled on the play, and she will take a trip to the foul line for a couple of foul shots. That is Ann Cavey, the foul party. She's a youngster from Mechanicsville, Iowa.
She got one of those look what I've just got in my hand passes there. I don't think she was expecting it, and the foul does go on Wessling, and that now, Ned, is 16 fouls on Creighton against two for the Lady Bears.
This KB, who is a 77% free throw shooter, has two shots. Now here comes Erica Hunte back into the ballgame to replace Tara Mitchum. And Morgan Hohenberger in to replace Carly Deer. Hohenberger, a freshman from Cooper, Texas. Second shot and KB.
Thank you.
23-10, Southwest Missouri State, 13-point advantage. Trapping defense by the Lady Bears. This jump shot is taken and comes up short by Tracy Jones. Ball goes out of bounds. It's off the hands of Tracy Jones, and it will be the Lady Bears basketball.
Ed Creighton just not passing or shooting very crisply right now. There's a lot of just ump to their shot. Not very smooth.
And I think much of that is attributable to the pressure and the trap that SMS is putting on them. The defense by Southwest Missouri State is certainly disturbing the Creighton attack. And we will have a whistle stopping the action. Foul on the Blue Jays. This will be team foul number 7 on Creighton, so the Lady Bears are in the bonus, and Jackie Stiles will be on the line for a 1-1.
Spanheimer with her second. That's a big second foul against her.
This is Jackie Stiles. She has a 1-1 opportunity here as the Lady Bears have been placed in the bonus situation. That means that Creighton as a team has committed more than 16 fouls. Points for Jackie Stiles and a 25-10 lead for the Lady Bears. There's that scramble defense, and it almost produced a turnover. Good rescue by Taya Allen, and here we have a turnover as the Lady Jays of Creighton succumb to the pressure of Southwest Missouri State, and the Lady Bears get it.
I think Creighton's still just searching for answers right now, Ned. You're absolutely right. The Lady Bears' pressure defense is just causing them problems both in the half court and the full court game right now.
Melody Campbell won't shoot very much. Hante, great feed to Cavey, and Cavey is fouled on the play, and she'll have a couple of shots from the foul line. That is team foul number 8 on Creighton. Foul in the act of shooting, says referee Lou Pitt, and Ann Cavey gets 2.
Ned, I cannot say enough what great passing, great ball movement the Lady Bears are showing this evening. You say Hante gave it up to Cavey right there, and Sinek picks up the foul.
KV, a junior from Mechanicsville, Iowa, 3-for-3 from the charity stripe. Second shot coming up. Well, we jinxed it.
10-of-12 right now from the line for the Lady Bears.
And a 26-10 lead for Southwest Missouri State. This is Angela Timmons. Whistle, what do we have? Offensive foul?
I
don't think so. No, it couldn't be.
Melody Campbell, I think, on the reach.
The way that Angela Timmons looked over at referee Lou Pitt, it was with a threatening gaze.
First on Campbell, third on the Lady Bears.
Carly Dearly comes back into the ball game, and Creighton will be inbounding. That's a non-shooting violation. This is Timmons, who is throwing the ball in or trying to, and finally launches one deep into the backcourt, rescued by Tracy Jones. The drive to the hole by Nenneman. We have a blocking foul on the Lady Bears.
Carol,
those of you who might be watching for the first time a Lady Bears telecast must realize that Southwest Missouri State, according to the fans, never commits a foul.
See if Campbell gets set. Cheryl Burnett thought she was there. Pretty close call, but the second foul on Campbell, and that'll get her a seat on the bench.
This will be Christy Nenneman, who has the duties on the foul line for Creighton. And Miss Nenneman is a 75% free throw shooter. Averaging nearly 11 points a game. That's 5 points for the freshman. There's Cheryl Burnett looking on. 26-11 is the score. Southwest Missouri State has the lead. That's Melody Campbell headed to the bench. Under 9 minutes remaining in the first half in Springfield, Missouri. 26-12, Southwest Missouri State owns the lead. Erica Vicente to Erica Hante. Ball is knocked out of bounds, but it's Tanya Senek who deflected it for Creighton.
about as good a defense as Creighton has played in the first half here. Really denial basketball.
Lady Bears will have 8 seconds on the shot clock. Morgan Hohenberger in the inbounding to Vicente. This is Vicente in the paint. Four points for Erica Vicente and a 28-12 lead for the Lady Bears, who were just shooting with astronomical proportions tonight. Angela Timmons, and she's traveling. And again, the Lady Bears defense forced the turnover. And we will take a timeout with 7:56 remaining in the first half. It's all Lady Bears, 28-12.
What's Food for Less been up to now? Well, we brought in a big shipment of U.S. number one russet potatoes. It's a 15-pound bag. What would you pay? $2? I don't think so. $1.50? Huh. 98 cents a bag. That's right, 98 cents a bag. For 15-pound U.S. number one russet potatoes. While supplies last. Springfield, Joplin.
The Midwest Sports Medicine Center is the area's oldest and most experienced sports medicine program focused on preventing, recognizing, managing, and rehabilitating sports injuries. We provide sports medicine coverage for several area schools. Athletes enjoy the benefit of our certified athletic trainers who work with SMS team physicians from St. John's. Our partnership provides a teaching environment that keeps us abreast of the latest techniques and innovations. Call the Midwest Sports Medicine Center today. We take the pain out of your game.
This is a Culligan drinking water system. Here's how it works. Imagine this is your family's drinking water, and this is the water in Peoria. Then this. It's a Culligan drinking water system. It's more than a pitcher or a faucet filter. It's a security system for your water.
Call your local Culligan dealer today.
Hey, Culligan man.
When disaster strikes, you can be there to help. As a member of the Air National Guard, feel the pride, get the experience. Join the Air National Guard and fuel your future.
Back at the Hammond Student Center in Springfield, Missouri, a 28-12 lead for Southwest Missouri State University. And the Lady Bears are a 48% shooting team for the year. They are shooting 64% for this game, as you look at Missouri Governor Bob Holden, who is newly elected. He is an SMS graduate and here to watch the proceedings tonight.
You don't suppose he used any pull to get a ticket tonight, do you?
He would have had to. We have a full house at the Hammond Student Center. Lady Bears have possession. There's Jackie Stiles. Angela Timmons with a rebound. Jackie has 8 points. Neneman into the lane and a whistle and an offensive foul. Charged to Christy Neneman, and that is her second personal foul.
Yeah, she came barreling through, and I'll tell you what, Ned, the Lady Bears are just getting to their spot so quick. Watch right here. Now, Vicente paid the price, but she got there, and that's got to be the third or fourth charge we've seen them draw this evening.
I believe that Christy Neneman may have been shaken up on that one, too. We've already had one player leave the game with what appears to be a significant injury, Kim Hover of Creighton. Erica Hunte, double team, now to Vicente, to Deer. Jackie Stiles is posted up. They get the ball to her. And a whistle stops the action, and Jackie is fouled.
And I think that's Spanheimer.
Let's take a look and see to whom they charged the foul. Chrissy Spanheimer was on her, and yeah, it's Chrissy Spanheimer who committed the foul.
Nope.
Now they're going to change the call. Now the officials have changed the call, apparently.
I think they're calling 3 seconds now. That went from a third possible foul on Spanheimer to 3 second turnover.
This ball's knocked out of bounds by Erica Vicente, and the Creighton Ball Club will retain possession. To inbound for Creighton will be Candace Bloomquist, who is into the ball game for the first time. 23 seconds on the shot clock for the Blue Jays. Bloomquist into Taya Allen. Now Angela Timmons, the point guard, takes control. 28-12, SMS in the lead. This is Timmons. Taya Allen outside to Chrissy Spanheimer, who misses the three, but the Creighton Blue Jays grab the rebound. Allen. Timmons for three.
He's a good one.
Angela Timmons has 9 points to lead the Creighton team in scoring, and she just bombed home a three. And for Angela, that is her 22nd successful play of the year. Ball is batted around, and Taya Allen has it for Creighton. Creighton is a 33% three-point shooting team. Oh, great pass underneath, and Allen scores. And that will result in a timeout for Southwest Missouri State as Taya Allen gets 2 points. It is suddenly 28-17 with 6:13 remaining in the first half. Well, coming up right after tonight's telecast will be ER, and you will see it right here on KY3, the place to be, ER, following our telecast of the SMS Lady Bears and the Creighton Blue Jays, and that Creighton ball club, which had gotten down early, Tom, is suddenly hot.
Well, and Angela Timmons gets all the credit, Ned. She is working out there. She's scoring, made a great down-low pass right there, all part of a 7-2 Creighton run right now that has kind of cut into, well, it's really cut into that 16-point lead. They've trimmed it down now to just 11.
Each of these teams in Missouri Valley Conference play on the women's side into the final two games of their regular season. The Missouri Valley Conference women's postseason tournament is here at the Hammond Student Center next weekend, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Jackie Stiles has it. Now Vicente. This is Erica Vicente. Hunte. Erica Hunte is blazing, folks. That's 12 points for Erica Hunte on a 4 point per game average. 30-17, Lady Bears. From the post position, Teresa Wessling can't get the ball to fall. It goes out of bounds, and the rock goes to SMS. Cheryl Burnett with her instructions to the team. 5:36 remaining in the first half, and a 30-17 lead for SMS. Jackie Stiles. This is Vicente. Erica Vicente.
Tell you what, the supporting cast is doing a great job of being a supporting cast to Jackie Stiles tonight.
This is Angela Timmons, and a whistle stops the action. It's a traveling violation on Angela Timmons. What's really interesting, I think, is the defense that Creighton has put on Jackie Stiles. Connie Urey told us that she wouldn't change all that much, yet they do have two players chasing her, and what that's doing is allowing a Lady Bear open, and SMS is capitalizing. 32-17. Over the Lady Bears. Here's Carly Deer by herself. 4 points for Carly Deer. Turnover, Vicente. And a foul on the play. And Erica Vicente will go to the line for SMS.
Coming unglued for Creighton right now.
Connie Urey calls a timeout with 4:52 remaining in the first half. It's a 30-second timeout. Let's watch this play by Carly Deer.
Well, you're going to see a great look by Vicente, and credit Deer for getting herself completely open right there.
And watch the pressure defense of the Lady Bears. They force the turnover. It's Deer with the interception, and Vicente draws the foul. And Connie Urey says, I need another 30 seconds to talk things over. 4:52 remaining in the first half, and a commanding 34-17 lead for Southwest Missouri State. And the Jackie count stands at 8. 8 points for Jackie Stiles, and Connie Urey not very happy with her team.
Wow, look at that look she's given them. I don't think she even talked to him in the timeout, Ned. I think she just grouped them together, kind of made them look at one another, because they are really breaking down in several facets right now.
In the ball game back in December, when the Lady Bears took on Creighton, December 30th, to be specific, it was 84-59, the Lady Bears winning in Omaha. Jackie had 20 points. Turnovers making the big difference in this one, and the Lady Bears are forcing it. This will be Erica Vicente on the line for Southwest Missouri State, and she will have 2 shots. Erica Hunte with the rebound, and folks, that is 14 points for Erica Hunte tonight. 3-point shot does not go off the front of the rim. Lady Bears have the rebound. Up court is Hohenberger. Knocked to the floor, and she traveled with it. And that's a good call. Morgan Hohenberger went up for the long pass, but knocked off balance, no foul there, and traveled when she rolled over.
I will say there was a little bump there, but not enough maybe for the official to call.
And now we have a foul, perhaps a frustration foul, called on Erica Vicente.
But still, only five team fouls on the Lady Bears right now.
37-17 SMS in the lead. This is Creighton's possession. Taya Allen getting the inbounds pass, and controlling it is Candace Bloomquist. She brings it over the midcourt line. Now Angela Timmons, all-conference performer. This is Spanheimer, and she's knocked off balance in the paint and fouled. It is a non-shooting violation and team foul number six on the Lady Bears.
Number one against Stiles.
Yeah, I really didn't see any contact.
Yeah, there was absolutely no contact there at all. I think they may be looking up and they see a 20-point game. You bet.
This is Danya Finch, who inbounds, triggering the attack for Creighton. Finds Timmons in the right wing. Taya Allen takes the shot. Does not go, and Carly Deer with the rebound for SMS. Lady Bears running. That's Vicente. Tara Mitchum, left wing. Vicente to Hunte. And to Mitchum, and Tara Mitchum draws the foul. Tara's very good at doing that. Upon establishing position down on the baseline, she's very active physically and able to, in fact, draw those fouls.
Look at the passing right here. And coming in right here is Neneman. And Ned, that's three now on Neneman.
So Tara Mitchum goes to the line. She is scoreless on the evening, but probably not for much longer. One of the better free throw shooters. Oh, my goodness. 88% free throw shooter, and she misses her first one.
Mitchum and Stiles are among the top 15 in the nation in free throw shooting.
And we take a timeout with 3:52 remaining in the first half. It's all Lady Bears. They lead Creighton 38-17.
Pay program, your utility payments are sent to us automatically from your bank.
Going to Branson, Missouri.
Yay!
They're taking my parents.
Hey, you can change the season shopping.
It makes me feel like a kid again.
It's where you send a friend. Dennis Hanks in Ozark, where folks come back again. Time after time for a big city selection in a small town atmosphere. That famous Hanks service, you can only find it here. For a great price from nice guys, you know you can depend on Dennis Hanks in Ozark. It's where you'd send a friend.
38-17, the Lady Bears had the lead. Creighton was making a comeback, Tom, and the Lady Bears have gone on a 10-0 run.
Well, they had the answer. Watch the missed free throw here. And keep your eye on Erica Hunte on the far side of the lane right here. Good positioning by Creighton, but not good enough. Deer gets the deflection, and Hunte's there with a solid left hand.
And it is Erica Hunte who leads the Lady Bears in scoring with 14. A surprise? You bet. She's averaging only 4 points a game. Jackie Stiles has eight. Here's the scramble defense on the part of the Lady Bears, and a timeout is called. No, it's a turnover. Danya Finch did not rescue the high pass in time, tried to call the timeout, and the official said, nope, that's not the case. Ball was out of bounds, and the Lady Bears have possession.
Got to go back, Ned. Neneman, I gave credit to that previous foul. It was Finch, in fact, who picked up her second.
Here's Tara Mitchum, free on the wing. That one does not go, and the rebound comes down to Creighton. two Lady Blue Jays battle for it, and Taya Allen picks up the loose ball. That's Menneman with the basketball. Menneman into the paint. He's an active player. No whistle on the play, and the Lady Bears come up with it. Shot cleanly blocked, according to the officials. Pacente will take the shot. That's 9 points tonight for Erica Pacente, and a 40-17 lead for SMS.
Finch dribbling out of bounds on the other side this time.
All right, nothing is going right for Creighton, is it? Donya Finch dribbling on the baseline because of the pressure that SMS is, in fact, forcing on the Blue Jays. Here is Timmons leaving the ballgame, as well as Christy Neneman. She is out, too. So the point will be handled now by Jenny Burns and Donya Finch. Lady Bears with possession. Vicente finds Jackie Stiles. Conte to Vicente. Rebound Stiles. She is halfway to that mark. Jackie Stiles with 10 points. ...42-17 Lady Bears. Donya Finch way off the mark. Sinek with a rebound, but dribbled off her foot. However, Creighton picked it up. This is Chrissy Spanheimer to Tanya Sinek. And now the jump shot by Jenny Burns off the mark, and the rebound pulled down by Southwest Missouri State. Vicente will lead the break. She'll take it to the goal.
And this is the kind of game you want to save for somewhere down the road, because everything's falling right for the Lady Bears.
Erica Vicente, coast to coast, and she takes it to the hoop and is fouled on the play. Foul committed by Jenny Burns, and now Vicente will try for the three-point play, and Erica Vicente has 11 points. And Cavey getting set to come back in. There's Miss Cavey from Mechanicsville, Iowa. She's going to replace Erica Hante, who leads all scorers in this game with 14. And Miss Hante gets a standing O from the big crowd. Who would have thunk that?
Three Lady Bears and double figures in the first half.
Vicente completes the three-point play. 45-17 Lady Bears.
Remember when it was an 11-point game? It's now an 18-0 run, or excuse me, 17-0 run for the Lady Bears.
Trap pressure by the Lady Bears. Sent it all the way across court. This is Spanheimer. She misses her shot. Rebound is pulled down by SMS, and Ann Keeley got one in the chops. The ball came up and hit her in at proboscis. However, Miss Cavey recovered fully, and the Lady Bears have possession. Jackie Stiles for three.
Oh, no. Ned, Jackie Stiles just moved to number two on the career list.
Number two all-time career scorer, passing Laurie Bowman. This is a better than five-minute drought now for Creighton. 13 points for Jackie, 48-17 Lady Bears. This is Donya Finch. And she quiets the crowd at least for a split second as Donya Finch fires on the tray. And that breaks a better than five-minute drought for Creighton.
And a 20-0 run.
Mitchum has the ball knocked out of her hands, but it's off the hands of the Creighton Blue Jays. 36 seconds remaining in the first half. As Connie Urey discusses things with one of the officials, that's Cheryl Burnett at whom you're looking. Lady Bears, with 20 seconds on the shot clock, will have possession. Vicente looks for a cutting Jackie Stiles, and she'll back it out towards center court. Here goes Jackie. Rebound, Cavey. Creighton had concentrated its defense on stopping Jackie Stiles, and Cavey got the loose ball. And now we have a foul committed by SMS as Tanya Sinek took the ball to the hole. This is a 30-point lead for Southwest Missouri State. 30-point advantage, 50-20. Lady Bears in a rout.
Vicente with her second. The miss by Stiles net at the other end, and Cavey in the best place to be. I mean, it's just everything is falling right.
This is Tanya Sinek, who will be on the line. She will have two shots. Miss Sinek is from Hot Springs, Arkansas. She is a senior, a 67% free throw shooter. That's Morgan Hohenberger at whom you're looking. He's a freshman for the Lady Bears. Second shot for Tanya Sinek. Fans want Jackie Stiles to shoot. Instead, it'll be Carly Deer. 3 seconds remain. Creighton will at least have an attempt. No, they won't either. They'll never get the shot off. And the first half comes to an end, and it has been a very one-sided first half in Springfield, Missouri. All the SNS Lady Bears, led somewhat surprisingly by Erica Hunte with 14 points, Jackie Stiles 13, and Erica Vicente with 12. Lady Bears 50, Creighton 21. Don't go away. Halftime ceremonies coming right up.
Life in a cubicle wasn't for you, so you go out alone and make your own way. Because there's pride knowing that this corporate ladder has one rung and you're already standing on it. Let us help you stand strong. At Alliance Blue Cross Blue Shield, we offer affordable, individual coverage for individual people like you. For a low monthly cost, our plans feature options like complete freedom to choose your doctor, low-cost doctor visits, and a broad network of doctors and hospitals. Other benefits include access to care across the United States, preventive care and wellness programs, and prescription drug coverage. Working for yourself has many rewards. Make sure good health is one of them. Call about individual coverage from Alliance Blue Cross Blue Shield.
At Lipscomb Mitsubishi, we'll do the math to show you how affordable a new Mitsubishi is during our special 1.9% financing sales event. This incredible rate is for 5 years, not 3 years like most others. A super sharp Montero Sport with no money down for as low as $383 a month. A sporty Eclipse with no money down starts at just $299 a month. A loaded Mitsubishi Galant ES for as low as $323 a month with no money down. When Lipscomb Mitsubishi does the math, you can believe it!
67 years ago, Springfield's landscape looked a lot different. But just west of town, Clell Barnes had an idea to bring furniture and appliances together under one roof, saving customers time and money. Hi, folks, this is Rick at Barnes Town & Country. Since the beginning, we've been striving to bring you the best in furniture with brands like Lazy Boy and Cochran, and appliances, too, by Whirlpool and KitchenAid. Heck, we're just a couple of good old boys selling furniture and appliances at Barnes Town & Country, 4 miles west of Chestnut and I-44 in historic Route 66.
Hazardous material accidents usually happen without warning. To ensure a quick response time when minutes matter, call us for a pre-contractual agreement. We're licensed and bonded. You need to know that you, your employees, and property are protected, and the federal and state agencies are satisfied. For over 15 years, Sunbelt has been responding to emergencies for industry and for local, state, and federal agencies. Sunbelt is equipped with state-of-the-art equipment to handle any type of hazardous materials. Call Sunbelt Environmental Services, 1-800-333-5052.
We welcome you back to the Hammond Student Center in Springfield, Southwest Missouri State's Lady Bears against the Creighton Lady Jays. And this halftime report is presented by Ozark Dodge, where you always get Mo. And Mo is what we have had in the first half here on KY3. Mo offense by the SMS Lady Bears, brought about by some terrific defense, Tom.
Well, great defense, great passing, and good, like I said earlier, good support work. In recent games, it's been the Jackie Stiles with very little help. And boy, tonight is she getting back up.
Jackie has 13 points. She's the second leading scorer on the Lady Bears team. The performance of Erica Hunte has been nothing short of sensational. Here's a young lady scoring only 4 points a game on the average, 14, brought about by the fact that Jackie's being shadowed.
Well, they're doubling up on Stiles, and as you so alertly pointed out, when that happens, every time someone should be open. Hasn't always been that way in recent games for the Lady Bears. Boy, tonight they're showing how you pay, make a team pay for doubling down on a great player.
The Creighton team is a good one, folks. They have 17 wins on the season, and they're a formidable force in the Missouri Valley Conference, but they have been completely taken out of their rhythm by that pressure defense of the Lady Bears. We want you to stay right where you are here on KY3. Lady Bears with a 50-21 lead at halftime in Springfield, Missouri.
from Ozark Chrysler.
You'll find the most powerful lineup of Dodge trucks in the Ozarks at Ozark Chrysler 5-Star Dodge. They have a great selection of Dakotas, Ram pickups, and Durangos. Big league trucks that are versatile, tough, and durable. Enjoy the thrift of savings and the thrill of driving one of these great-looking trucks now at Ozark Chrysler 5-Star Dodge.
We'll come and get a 5-star deal and drive away with more appeal.
Approaching the century mark in serving the corporate and individual legal needs of Southwest Missouri, the law firm of Neal & Newman is positioned for continued leadership into the 21st century. A full-service, locally-owned, multidisciplinary law firm, Neal & Newman has the integrity, history, and tradition that we've come to rely upon. One of the largest law firms in the area, Neal & Newman is proud to be an active participant in many leading civic organizations. Your partner for the 21st century, the law firm of Neal & Newman, LLP.
Come experience the Berber lifestyle at Midwest Rug, your local Mohawk Color Center store. Midwest Rug teams up with Mohawk, the most widely recognized name in carpet, to bring you a super value on four Berber patterns, each with 9 color choices, and all are stain resistant. And with this special pricing, you could carpet your entire home for as little as $1,680, and that's installed, with pad and tax included. Financing is available. Come live the Berber lifestyle at your Mohawk Color Center store, Midwest Rug.
Dairy Quality Check Chocolate Milk.
At Springfield Trust Company, we never forget what contributed to our phenomenal growth during the 90s and what will carry us successfully into the future.
The nicest thing about it is the personal service that I've received there. I don't feel like a number in a computer database. I feel like they know me and they care about my success in reaching my goals.
I placed my trust with them and have been very satisfied.
Springfield Trust Company. Celebrating 10 years of serving the Ozarks.
Back in Springfield, Missouri, we are most pleased that you are with us on KY3 on this Thursday evening. It's Lady Bears basketball, and the Lady Bears have routed Creighton in the first half to the tune of 50-21. And Tom Astin has been a clinic in expert shooting and expert passing by the Lady Bears. They've done a number on the Blue Jays.
If Cheryl Burnett has her voice raised at all in that locker room, I can't imagine what it would be for. This looks like a team that practiced 5 minutes before this thing started. They've done everything they probably drew up on the blackboard.
Their defense has been absolutely spectacular, as only the Lady Bears can do. When they turn on that scramble, which is actually a trap press, teams melt pretty quickly.
Creighton's wilting real quick tonight, yeah.
They have indeed. Well, folks, it's time now for the Waka Waka Play of the Half, brought to you by Justice Jewelers, and I think this exemplifies the play of the Lady Bears.
It's not that flashy, but you just pointed out so well. Now, this tells just exactly what they did. Vicente at the top of the key saw Deer made a fake one way, came around, freed herself up, easy off the glass like that. Lots of points and lots of assists, and watch what Deer did. She turned right around off the play. Got a steal.
And to Erica Vicente, who drew the foul and went to the line for a couple of them. And that's the Waka Waka Play of the Half, presented by Justice Jewelers, and it has been all Southwest Missouri State with that 50-21 lead. Now, this is a talented Creighton team. This is a huge margin to try to overcome, but this Creighton ball club can play. Angela Timmons is a fine player.
Timmons is a great player. Spanheimer has not been a factor. She's a great player on the floor. They lost Hover to injury, so they've got some problems, and I don't know if Timmons, I really don't know how much she can carry them, especially when you're down almost 30 points.
Significant about Chrissy Spanheimer, who is one of the leaders on this Creighton team. She's given the charge of guarding Jackie Stiles and has really done a pretty good job of it, but it's perhaps taken away a little bit from Chrissy's offense, and she really has not been a factor. Big lead for the Lady Bears. Much more coming your way right here on KY3.
Yesterday, your love for her was strong. Today, your love for her continues to grow. Tomorrow, you'll love her more than ever. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow, the 3-diamond anniversary band from Justice Jewelers, starting at just $750. The perfect expression for a lifetime of love.
You know, I used to be pro-choice, but with new medical advances, unborn babies are now being saved before birth with blood transfusions, even heart surgery. I'm confused. Why are some little ones, while still in the womb, treated with miracles, and other tiny babies, the very same ages and perfectly healthy, aborted? Pro-choice just doesn't make sense to me anymore.
Reliable Toyota Superstore is overstocked. 345 new Toyotas.
Including the all-new Sequoias, Highlanders, and RAV4s.
Choose from 50 Camrys for just $200 over dealer invoice.
Lease Corollas for just $178 for 36 months with 14-10 cash or trade due at signing.
Fuel-efficient Echos for just $11,937.
Oh, and $5,000 discounts on 4Runners.
Back to the bun deals at Reliable Toyota Superstore.
Sunshine and 65 in Springfield.
There's a world of opportunity out there waiting to be explored. OTC offers degrees recognized by local employers, tuition you can afford, and is accredited by the North Central Association that accredits SMS, Drury, and other major colleges and universities. An OTC education means you'll be qualified for more than just a job. You'll be on a career path, ready for future advancement opportunities. With 28 programs, OTC has a field of study to satisfy just about every area of interest. Call OTC today to learn more. It's the level of quality and the personal care that keeps them coming back. Shop where the pros have shopped for over 75 years.
Welcome back to the Lady Bears on KY3, and we welcome you back to the Hammond Student Center, where Southwest Missouri State has dismantled Creighton here in the first half, 50-21. And Tom, the statistics pretty much tell everything, and let's take a look at those numbers now, brought to you by the Vitae Society, and they are telltale stats, to say the very least.
Well, these are great stats. These are just fantastic stats from the Lady Bears' standpoint. Both teams, 29 attempts. Look what the Lady Bears have done, 62% from the field tonight. They've dominated at the line because they've, of course, gotten there more often. The rebounding's a little more even. 14 turnovers, really critical against Creighton, and look at the points in the paint. How many games in the last month or so have the Lady Bears seen that situation flip-flop, so they're really dominating inside.
Of those 19 points in the paint, Erica Hunte is responsible for 14 of them. Now, one of the mainstays for the Creighton team, Kim Hover, went down because of a knee injury. We checked on her. She's still here in the building, but apparently she's out for the remainder of this game, an apparent knee injury, and they have just taken her a set of crutches. That's too bad, too, because she's one of the top rebounders.
But she really is. She was their leading rebounder, in fact, in the half. You remember when she went out? She leaves with four rebounds. No one even close for Creighton.
Well, folks, we've been delighted that you're with us for the halftime numbers and activities. This halftime report has been a presentation of Ozark Dodge, where you always get Mo. And that's what we have coming up, Mo Basketball.
Hi, this is Dolly. You ever wonder why I personally guarantee that my Dixie Stampede is the most fun place to eat? Well, won't you see for yourself? All this family fun plus a four-course feast. Come visit my Dixie Stampede dinner and show. It's the most fun place to eat in Brandsville. I guarantee it.
I'm Dr. Norman Gary, and I'm a bee expert. All right, bee.
Dr. Norman Gary will do some pretty outrageous things.
I've been stung probably around 75,000 times.
But would Norm Gary ever get car insurance that didn't come with a State Farm agent?
Car insurance with no State Farm agent? Now that makes me nervous.
For car insurance, be like this State Farm customer. And get an agent you can rely on.
You got six legs, use them, baby.
Plus competitive rates.
Hi, friends. It's Youngblood Chrysler's minivan sale. Thanks for making us number one. We're the number one seller minivans for Chrysler in Southwest Missouri. Thank you for making us a minivan center. Every minivan in stock is $1 over factory invoice and has $1,500 rebate or 0.9% available. Or $1,000 customer cash with 2.9% available. Now's the time for a great deal from your number one minivan center. So come into Youngblood Chrysler, your minivan headquarters. What a price.
to have this done and to have a full set of teeth would really boost my self-esteem so much. Even thinking about it, I smile.
They're amazing. Better than I ever thought I could have. It was worth every bit of it. The experience, the finance. I am a different person now. I smile so much more. I feel like $1 million.
For more information on how you can enhance your natural teeth, call Dr. George Graham, the Smile Architect, at 889-GRIN.
It will be loud with fierce rivalries, record-setting performances, and you can be there at the end. Get your tickets today for the 2001 State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball Tournament, March 8th through 10th at Hammond Student Center in Springfield, Missouri. Call the Southwest Missouri State Athletics Ticket Office at 417-836-7678. Don't miss the very best hoops in the heartland.
Welcome back to the Lady Bears on KY3. I'm Ned Reynolds, along with Tom Ash, speaking to you from the Hammond Student Center tonight, and it is a huge lead for the Lady Bears, 50-21, and Tom asked, how significant is the fact that the Lady Bears are ahead?
Not to be overlooked. Let's take a look at some quick highlights here. Watch what happens here. Vicente kicks it back out to Hante right at the free throw line, knocks it down right here. Just more teamwork that we saw. Jackie Stiles is gunning for number one tonight, but she moves into number two all time, picking up number 3,116 right here on this score.
Right there with that three-pointer that rolled around and bounced and fell through, and she passed Lori Bowman of Drake University, and Drake University, which has the lead in the Missouri Valley Conference, is in the process, in the early going, of being upset by Wichita State. Drake trailing in the ballgame by 13 points over in Wichita, Kansas, and Drake is here to play the Lady Bears on Saturday. It will be Creighton's basketball to start the action. That's Tracy Jones, who is handed the ball by referee Lou Pitt. And we are set to begin action in the second half at Springfield, Missouri's Hammond Student Center. And the Lady Bears pick right up on that defense. Angela Timmons with an acrobatic move to rescue that high pass. 50-21, Southwest Missouri State leading. The jump shot is taken and scored by Jenny Burns of Creighton, and they are her first 2 points of the game. Sarah Mitchum looks for Jackie Stiles and finds her at the top of the key. Jackie will take the shot.
We're drawing close.
Jackie Stiles is 5 points away from becoming the all-time leading scorer in the history of women's Division I college basketball. And here's a steal by Jackie. And she is now 3 points away from that record.
And everyone in here knows it.
Fans are on their feet in the Hammond Student Center. 54-23 is the lead for the Lady Bears, and a foul. That was Tracy Jones, who took the ball to the hole and gets fouled by the Lady Bears. So, to update you very quickly, 54-23 is the score. Southwest Missouri State in the lead, and Jackie Stiles now with 17 points on the night. 3 points away from breaking the mark of Patricia Hoskins, who is in attendance here at the Hammond Student Center, having come up from Greenville, Mississippi, a little bit earlier this afternoon. Tracy Jones' first shot is missed, as Jones has not scored yet in the ballgame. Fifty-four to 24 is the lead for Southwest Missouri State. Down court come the Lady Bears. Here's Jackie for the record.
She got it.
Thunderous applause raining down from the huge throng at the Hammond Student Center as Jackie Stiles sets the new college scoring record. Tracy Jones connecting on that three for Creighton. Jackie hitting a tray to give her 20 and breaks by one the mark of Kim Hoskins. Here is Jackie again, and she now has 22 to add to that record. The fans in mass, better than 9,000 on their feet. This is Chrissy Spanheimer. She misses the tray. The rebound, the long rebound, hauled in by Carly Deer. It's SMS 59, Creighton 26. Conte loses the ball, double teamed, and Creighton will come up with the turnover. Carly Deer with the rebound. Here are the Lady Bears breaking. Tara Mitchum can't rescue the pass, just a little bit behind her. 17-23 remaining in the basketball game at the Hammond Student Center as substitutions come in for both teams.
I've never seen 9,000 people that knew the exact score of an individual like these people did. I mean,
now the Lady Bears call a timeout with 17-23 remaining, and listen to the crowd. Folks, let's take a look at the record-breaking shot. Jackie Stiles with the tray.
Very fitting the way they set this up. Mitchum over to Stiles. Spanheimer looking her down. Nothing but cords.
And that one established a new all-time scoring record for Jackie Stiles. She is the nation's leading scorer all-time NCAA Division I women's basketball. 59-26, Southwest Missouri State in a rout. Scramble defense by the Lady Bears with a turnover, and here goes Fowler. Jackie had 13 at halftime. We have played just, not quite 3 minutes, and she already has 24, 11 points already. That's how quickly Jackie Stiles can score. This is Spanheimer. They are the first 2 points of the night for Chrissy Spanheimer of Creighton. And that's interesting because Chrissy is a 9 point per game scorer, capable of much better things offensively. Stiles. She's traveling on the play. Traveling violation against Jackie Stiles. 61-28 is the score, and there's Jackie Stiles, and she's leading the game, folks.
Pressure's off.
There she is, the all-time leading scorer in women's Division I basketball history. Spanheimer has the basketball now to Teresa Wessling. She'll throw. The shot is rejected by Ann Pavey, and a foul committed.
Cynic, I believe.
Let's take a look at this block again here by Ann Pavey of the Southwest Missouri State Lady Bears. 61-28 is the score.
Slides along nicely and goes straight up. Gets the deflection, then you see Cynic come right there and catch her on the left arm.
Team foul number one for Creighton here in the second half. Tara Mitchum into the paint. Lady Bears have all gears meshing tonight. That's 3 points tonight for Tara. Angela Timmons, blasting 1-0. She is the first of Creighton's Lady Jays to get into double figures in scoring tonight. Great pass to Deer. No-look pass from Erica Vicente. Carly Deer gets the points, but Erica Vicente with a sensational assist. 65-30, all SMS. Timmons stripped of the basketball, and the Lady Bears have it. Vicente to Hohenberger. And the foul committed by Chrissy Spanheimer of Creighton. This will result in Morgan Hohenberger going to the line for Southwest Missouri State. Now, this Hohenberger for the year is 20 of 30 from the foul line. That translates into 67% shooting, but averaging only 3 points per game.
In for the Blue Jays, number 23, Dana Hicks, and number 24, Tracy Jones.
Now Carly Deere leads the game for SNS. Lady Bears have another game on the schedule 48 hours from now against Drake. That will be here at the Hammond Student Center. And a game that you will see on KY3 as Hohenberger makes both of her foul shots. And we take a timeout with 15-18 remaining in the ball game. All SNS 67-30.
It's where you send a friend. Dennis Hanks and Ozark, where folks come back again, time after time, for a big city selection in a small town atmosphere. That famous Hanks service, you can only find it here. For a great price from nice guys, you know you can depend on Dennis Hanks in Ozark. It's where you'd send a friend. Machino knows what I like.
For your patio, deck, pool, or boat, it's quality outdoor furniture from Machino. Choose the classic warmth of wood furniture in Jara or teak. Consider traditional wrought iron or cast aluminum. Experience the rainbow of carefree cushions and slings at Machino's. On Campbell, just two blocks north of Bass Pro.
Machino knows what I like. Machino knows what I like.
Injured on the job? Call a lawyer who has never lost a workers' compensation case.
I'm Dr. Brad Bradshaw, physician, surgeon, and lawyer. I've never lost a workers' compensation case. I cannot predict the outcome of your case, and I don't take every case. But every case I take to win.
If you have a workers' compensation claim, call a lawyer who is also a doctor. Brad Bradshaw, MD, JD, a licensed physician, surgeon, and lawyer with 20 years combined medical and legal experience. Call 890-8888.
Transportation assistance provided through Fisk Limousines and Martin Leasing, serving customers from their new location at Chestnut Expressway and East Traffic Way in Springfield. For all your transportation needs, it's Fisk Limousines and Martin Leasing with vehicles for any occasion. Call 862-2900.
Delighted to have you with us on KY3 tonight for Lady Bears basketball. 15-18 remaining in the game, and the Lady Bears are waxing the team from Omaha, Nebraska. 67-30, Lady Bears over Creighton. And SMS goes to a trap press that they picked up at half court. Blue Jays have possession. This will be Finch from way out. And Danya Finch pours home a tray. That is her second tray of the night. All her points coming from three-point distance. She has six. 67-33, Southwest Missouri State. Mitchum into the paint. Five points tonight for Tara as the offense and defense, all phases of the Lady Bears game, clicking with perfection. Creighton forced to keep the ball out on the perimeter. They just simply cannot get it inside. This is Tanya Senek. Battle for the rebound is pulled off by whom? It's a scrum underneath. Battling for it, Teresa Wessling of Creighton, and a whistle stops the action. And we will have a foul charged to Southwest Missouri State. The lead to Morgan Hohenberger, a freshman.
It's going to be her first. Ned, with that last make by Tara Mitchum, the Lady Bears are shooting over 70% from the field tonight.
And Tara Mitchum leaving the game for Southwest Missouri State, getting a high five from Cheryl Burnett. Give those 2 points to Teresa Wessling. They are her first two of the night. 69-35, Southwest Missouri State leading. Under 15 minutes remaining in the game, which has become quite one-sided. The Lady Bears win tonight and a Drake loss at Wichita State, and these teams would be tied for the lead. Here's Kavy underneath. Stephanie Busby from El Dorado Springs, one of the newcomers, one of the tall post players on this team, battling for the rebound, is fouled.
Sinek.
Holding violation, and it's Sinek who committed that foul. Tanya Sinek. Now Kinga Keach comes into the game, the 6'7 junior college transfer for Southwest Missouri State, along with Jackie Stiles back in. Jackie has 24 points. She has established that record. It came on a trade just a short time ago. Lady Bears have possession. That's Keach. Lady Bears are going tall. Here is a steal by Tanya Sinek, and she scores for Creighton. Tanya Sinek with the heads-up play. 69-37, Lady Bears. Campbell to Deer, and we had Carly Deer trying to set up the backdoor play with Jackie running off a pick. Jackie Stiles draws the foul on the play. Each team has three fouls. The Lady Bears will be inbounding underneath their own basket, and Melody Campbell will trigger the attack for Southwest Missouri. Campbell, one of the five seniors, to Stiles, and Jackie either had the ball knocked out of her hands or lost it, and the official says she lost it. And we will take a timeout here at the Hammond Student Center with 13:30 remaining. This is a 30-second timeout. 13:30 remaining in the game and a 69-37 lead for SMS.
Well, believe it or not, Cheryl Burnett had a puzzled look on her face as her players came to the huddle, and the way they're playing, you would think she... But even the smallest little mistake gets her attention, and so she brings them together and says, put it back together and we'll see what we can do.
Let's take a look at the all-time scorers now in Division I history. And you see Jackie Stiles has, by 5 points, surpassed Patricia Hoskins from Mississippi Valley State, who set the mark in 1989. And Miss Hoskins is here in attendance tonight. Lori Ballman from Drake Third, Shamiqua Holtzclaw, Cheryl Miller. That's some pretty heady company, Tom asked.
Well, she's been passing big names for the last few weeks, and she put herself on top this season.
Long bomb by Bloomquist. In and out, no good. Deer with a rebound. Lady Bears want a break. There goes Jackie. There is probably, in this reporter's opinion, not a better one-on-one player in the country than Jackie Stiles.
You can see her, but you can't stop her.
26 points. The pressure defense now has forced Tanya Sinek to call the timeout. So the Creighton Ball Club, with the trap pressure of SMS, forced into a 30-second timeout with 12:56 remaining in the game and a massive 71-37 lead for Southwest Missouri State. We remind you to stay right here on KY3ER. Will be forthcoming right after the game. As you well know, KY3 the place to be, and the Lady Bears will be here on KY3 Saturday afternoon at 2:15 with their regular season finale taking on the Drake Bulldogs.
I think they're going to tell us how big a crowd we've got here this evening, Ned. They haven't shown us yet. There it is. Second largest women's game in the history of this facility, 91-55.
Well, just as they do that, just as we announce the attendance, Christine Neneman breaks free on an inbounds pass and scores an uncontested layup. 71-39 is the damage as Christine Neneman tallies two for Creighton. Here's Jackie Stiles. And Neneman with a rebound for Creighton. Donya Finch. Now to Sinek. Nice little turnaround move by Teresa Wessling. Creighton playing with a little bit more energy here in the second half. They perhaps have caught the Lady Bears in something of a down moment. 71-41 is the score. Jackie on the left wing. Oh, great lob pass to Stephanie Busby, and the El Dorado Springs, Missouri freshman, gets fouled on the play. Excellent pass on the give and go and the little backdoor play, and Stephanie Busby draws the foul.
Lady Bears have been textbook tonight, Ned. I mean, every time they wanted to throw the ball where they wanted it, it's landed in the hands of the teammate. Fourth foul on Wessling.
Miss Busby, an all-Missouri selectee from El Dorado Springs, is a 70% free throw shooter. But evidently, that was not in the act of shooting. I thought for sure it was, but that's not the case. So the Lady Bears inbound. This is Carly Deer. She loses the ball. Ball is knocked out of bounds, and it's off the knees of Carly Deer, and Creighton will get possession. Taya Allen will be triggering the attack for Creighton. And Tanya Sinek will dribble against the pressure of Melody Campbell. This is Finch. Finch threw it away. She saw Tanya Senek fake one way and go the other, and Tanya Senek went for the fake. So it is a turnover, and we'll take a timeout with 11:42 remaining in the ballgame in Springfield, Missouri, Southwest Missouri State, 71-41.
The fire is out. Now what? The storm is over. Now what? The blueprints are complete. Now what? The broken water pipe is fixed. Now what? Fire. Storms. Remodeling projects or flooding. Call Kimco Construction and get the job done right. As owner Hal Grissom says, put your job on our backs. Kimco Construction is a proud member of the Home Builders Association. Call Kimco at 881-8147 today.
Everyone wants an SUV, but the price tag is just too high for many people. But at Lipscomb Suzuki, we've got two SUVs under $20,000 that are easy on the pocketbook, easy to drive, easy on the gas, and easy to get into. A sporty four-wheel drive Suzuki V6 Grand Vitara is only $17,995. Or the seven-passenger Suzuki XL7 is priced at only $19,995. These quality imports come from a manufacturer whose name you know and trust. When Lipscomb Suzuki says the price is right, you can
believe it!
50 years ago, a great Ozark dining tradition began. Today, a whole new generation has discovered Aunt Martha's Pancake House. Isn't it time you visited your Aunt Martha?
Ethel Curbo and her team will jump through hoops for you.
Call Ethel Curbo for all your realty needs at 887-6664.
SMSU is holding free workshops on filing taxes online with the IRS. For times and location, call 836-6660.
Huge lead for the Lady Bears, 71-41, and why is Jackie Stiles the player that she is? How about this little move?
Goes, fakes twice there, in the middle of her dribble there, fakes, and just clears out the lane and does it all by herself.
Tanya Senek, who had the dubious honor of trying to guard Jackie on that play, left clutching, could not do a thing. 71-41, Lady Bears, Southwest Missouri State in possession. Here's Jackie Stiles, left wing. Deer to Campbell, now to Stiles. Back to Melody Campbell, who will take it to the hole. Melody Campbell will go to the foul line. She will have a couple of foul shots. 1 point of the evening for the senior from Claremore, Oklahoma. Not one of the real big scorers on this ball club, but the floor general, the Lady Bear who really makes them go. Jackie with some conversation from Cheryl Burnett. That's Connie Urey at whom you're looking now. 9-year veteran coach at Creighton. Full court pressure by the Lady Bears. That's Neneman up court for Creighton. Taya Allen underneath and is fouled on the play. And I believe they'll charge the foul to King DeKeesh. Good fast break effort on the part of Creighton as Southwest Missouri State went with full court pressure and the Blue Jays broke it. Now some of the shock troops are coming in for Southwest Missouri State. Tiny McMorris is taking off her jersey. She'll be in. And KB coming in. Morgan Hohenberger about to report in. This is Taya Allen on the line. This is her first foul shot. Keesh, Busby, and Deer leaving for the Lady Bears. Second shot, Taya Allen. Rebound. And a foul again. This time it was Tracy Jones who draws the foul from the Lady Bears. And it'll be team foul number 5 on Southwest Missouri State. And this is Tracy Jones, who is a junior from Ankeny, Iowa, who will be on the line. And she'll have a couple of foul shots. Creighton completely out of sync, Tom. They can't get anything.
Well, nothing's working. The frustration factor, they look all the way back to when they got it to within 11 in the first half, and it's been an uphill battle and just nothing ever since.
Four consecutive missed foul shots, but the Blue Jays do get the rebound. This is Taya Allen. Her shot, she had to alter it. Ball goes out of bounds, and it is off the hands of Tiny McMorris of SNS. It will be Creighton's possession. This will be Tracy Jones to trigger the attack. Bounce pass to Neneman. Ball is battled for, goes out of bounds, and I believe it's off the knees of Hohenberger.
Either that or she may have been standing out of bounds. I don't know, but nevertheless, another effort and another opportunity for Creighton.
30-second timeout called by SMS with 10:58 remaining in the game and a 72-41 lead for Southwest Missouri State. As we mentioned, as far as the Lady Bears schedule is concerned, if you look at Connie Urie of Creighton, SMS will close the regular season Saturday at the Hammond Student Center, Senior Day, and the Lady Bears will be hosting break in what would appear right now to be a battle for first place in the Missouri Valley Conference. Then the ladies' teams will take the better part of a week off, and all of them, other than the bottom two teams in the Missouri Valley, eight of them will congregate here in Springfield for the Missouri Valley Conference Women's Tournament, which begins next Thursday, a week from today. Timmons inbounding for Creighton. This is Allen, and Taya Allen traveled with the basketball. She didn't know what to do with it.
Well, I think she was looking to pass, and she thought she'd dribble, and just another turnover, and then the problems just continued.
Jackie Stiles brings it over the midcourt line for SMS. She has 26 points tonight. It was a Trey, which was the record setter for Jackie. Ann Cavey into the paint, and she is fouled, and she'll go to the line for a couple of shots.
Neneman with the foul.
And that's Ann Cavey from Mechanicsville, Iowa. She is a junior and a very good free throw shooter. After the ball game, and we will try to present to you as much as we can, there will be some ceremonies honoring Jackie and her new record. But we also want to invite you to stay tuned for ER, which is coming up right here on KY3 following the telecast. Neneman to the goal. Oh, that's a great move by Christy Neneman. She has 10 points. Now the Lady Bears down court. Cavey double-team. McMorris does not get the basketball to fall, and a foul committed by Creighton.
Going to go against Timmons, and that'll be her first.
Angela Timmons committing the foul, as Tom told you, and Tiny McMorris, Latanya is the given first name, goes to the line.
Cavey got it here, and in they come, and you'll see the pass off to Tiny. Over the back came Timmons.
Tiny's been to the line only five times this year. Carly Deere coming back in for SMS.
Back in for your Lady Bears, number 43, Carly Deere. And
then
for the Blue Jays, number 12, Sarah
Hildebrand. That's Tiny McMorris, number 41. Another of the seniors on this ball club. 75-43, Southwest Missouri State. Way, way out in front. The drive to the goal and the foul. That's Tracy Jones who draws the foul from SMS.
It'll be pretty ragtag the next 10, I think, Ned.
Kind of gives that appearance, doesn't it? The Saturday finale from here at the Hammond Student Center in Springfield will start at 2:15. It's a 2:15 tip-off, and you'll see the game here on KY3. Already an expected large crowd on hand as Tracy Jones connects for Creighton. Carly Deere with the rebound. Here's Jackie on the break. She is amazing, folks. 28 points for Jackie Stiles, and now we have a turnover down court. Angela Timmons turns it over for Creighton, and the Lady Bears will get it back. 77-44, and we still have 10 minutes remaining in the game. Deere with a pass to Cavey, off Cavey's hands, and intercepted by the Blue Jays. This is Neneman, and Stiles with an unbelievable piece of defense coming right up behind Christy Neneman and knocking it away.
Perfect fleece job by Jackie Stiles. Avoided contact, got nothing but the ball.
She is so quick. Tracy Jones inbounding. And the turnaround jump shot by Sarah Hildebrand. They are her first 2 points of the game, and now a turnover by the Lady Bears. This is Timmons up court for Creighton. Angela splits a double team, and the goal is waved off by Lou Pitt. Foul on Southwest Missouri State.
Against Stiles, number two on her.
9:44 remaining in the game. Here's the play.
Here they come. Watch Stiles as she sets. Nope, got a hand up on the arm there. I thought Hohenberger might have got whistled for the move, but they called it on Stiles.
There's Jackie leaving the game for the second time. Congratulations all around.
We're in a 1-1 now. I think the players were expecting an inbounds and were running around trying to set for it.
This is the scoring average of Jackie Stiles, who is the reigning national scoring champion from last year. Look at the progression there. 20.6 as a freshman, then up to 25. Last year led the nation at 27.8, and this year 30.9. Foul shot by Angela Timmons. She now has 12.
And wouldn't you think that as teams got to know a little bit about her, they'd find a way to slow her down, but she just has gotten better and better and better.
Part of that attributable to the SMS attack. It's an up-tempo attack, and Jackie can go one-on-one with anyone. 13 points for Angela Timmons, 77-48 is the score in favor of Southwest Missouri. Mild pressure applied by Creighton. Erica Vicente brings it over the midcourt line. This is Mitchum. Great pass to Vicente. That was an excellent assist by Tara Mitchum. Good piece of positioning by Erica Vicente. She has 14 points on the night, but give the big A the assist to Tara Mitchum. This is Tanya Senek. Finds a cutting Bloomquist. And now Hildebrand outside. This bomb is thrown in for the Creighton Lady Jays. That number 22 is a pretty good little player, folks. That's Christy Neneman. Turnover. Here come the Blue Jays. Tanya Senek to the hole. That's 5 points for Tanya. 79-53. Lady Bears hustle it down. This is Ann Cavey on the post, double teamed, almost lost the ball. Mitchum picks it up, goes to the hole, and draws the foul. And Tara Mitchum will take a couple of shots from the foul line.
Neneman will pick up her fourth right there. Good ball movement, that all the way around the top, and once Mitchum saw the lane open up, in she went.
Neneman, only a freshman out of Omaha, Nebraska, she's going to see considerable playing time for this Creighton team. Highly successful Cheryl Burnett looking on.
And Ned, we really haven't talked about Tara Mitchum's ankle and the injury she suffered at Wichita, and she seems to have been back on it strong this season.
Well, you can see it's the left ankle because it's heavily taped, but she has moved very well on it. Hildebrand has the ball knocked away, but the Blue Jays get it back, and Hildebrand has the shot blocked by Cavey, rescued by the Lady Bears, but then suddenly thrown off the bottom of the backboard by Morgan Hohenberger, and that constitutes out of bounds, and Creighton will get possession with 13 seconds on the shot clock. And another whistle stops the action as bodies go to the floor. That's Senek, Tanya Senek, being helped up, and she's hobbled now. Gee, Creighton can't afford to lose anybody else. They have already lost Kim Hover, one of their powerful post players. She went down with an apparent knee injury early in this ballgame.
That was the third foul on Vicente.
This is Tanya Senek, resident of Hot Springs, Arkansas, on the line. Rebound pulled down by Ann Cavey, and the Lady Bears have it. Under 8 minutes remaining in this ballgame. Tiny McMorris back in there. Vicente underneath to McMorris. This is Tara Mitchum. Nice turnaround move, and she is going to be charged with an offensive foul. Oh, a traveling. I beg your pardon. It is not an offensive foul. Traveling on Tara Mitchum, and we do have the timeout. That's one of the few things the fans have been booing here tonight. Huge lead for the Lady Bears, 80-53.
This Rolex is the perfect combination of delicacy and strength. You can see it today at Maxim's. From the oyster case to the more than 200-piece movement, every element must meet the most exacting standards before the timepiece can wear the Rolex crown. This remarkable watch took an entire year to create. Time well spent. To see a selection of Rolex timepieces, visit Maxim's, your official Rolex jeweler.
Why don't you get us something to cool this fire down?
I got just the thing. I got too long for that fire.
With a great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
That's not that bad.
It's a huge lead for the Lady Bears of Southwest Missouri State, 80-53 with 7:42 remaining. Now let's check the clean sweep rebound brought to you by Sunbelt Environmental for 15 years, your full-service environmental company. Tom?
Have not been a lot of misses by the Lady Bears tonight, but they've taken advantage. Carly Deer with 10, and Over still the leading rebounder, despite the fact she hasn't been here since midway through the first half for Creighton.
Under 8 minutes remaining in the game. All SMS, 80-53. Creighton with the basketball. Blue Jays have played better basketball here in the second half. That shot is rejected. Sarah Hildebrand with the shot, and she tried to challenge the trees underneath, and it didn't work. Now Senek with the shot. It doesn't go, and Ann Cavey has the rebound for SMS, and the Lady Bears will break. Vicente to Mitchum. Into the paint for Tara. Whistle. Blocking foul on Creighton. And Tara Mitchum will go the line. That is the 10th team foul on the Creighton Lady Jays, so the Lady Bears are in the double bonus. This will be Tara Mitchum, and she'll have two foul shots, and the Springfield Glendale product has 6 points on the night. Missouri Valley Conference Men's Tournament gets underway tomorrow with the play-in games up at the Santa Center in St. Louis, and Southwest Missouri State Bears will be playing in that first play-in game at 6 o'clock when they meet Wichita State. And we'll check on the latest score of the Wichita State break game. Wichita State was up by 13 points at last report. Danya Finch. Rebound Hohenberger. Lady Bears breaking again. This is Vicente. Steal by Senek. Held ball. I'll call a held ball, and possession arrow points to Southwest Missouri State. 6:41 remaining in this ball game, and an 82-53 lead for the Lady Bears as more substitutions come in for SMS. Cheryl Burnett directing the symphony, and that's what it has been here at the Hammond Student Center tonight. Vicente off a pick, finds Melody Campbell. Now Hohenberger tries a pass to a double team to Stephanie Busby, and Creighton comes up with the interception. Angela Timmons back in there now for Creighton. That's Spanheimer in the corner. Sarah Cizak has the basketball now. It's out to Chrissy Spanheimer. And from the corner, Cizak loses or misses the shot, and a held ball results. I believe that's what they're going to call. Well, referee Lou Pitt says apparently there's a violation. Has to talk it over with one of the other officials.
Yeah, possession going to go to Creighton.
So they did call the held ball is what it was, and the possession arrow points to the Blue Jays. So Creighton will get possession here with 6:02 remaining in the ballgame. Tracy Jones inbounding for Creighton. Spanheimer has it taken away. Vicente. And again, you see the pressure defense employed by the SMS Lady Bears producing another turnover. And now a foul out at midcourt by Melody Campbell. Angela Timmons is the foul party. And Jackie Stiles will get set to come back in for the Lady Bears with under 6 minutes remaining. Jackie has 28 points, set the new scoring record early in the second half. Melody Campbell was just fouled out of this ballgame. Melody will lead the contest with 2 points. She's not one of the big scorers on this ball club, but is the floor general, directing the attack, and she has directed it to an 84-53 lead as Angela Timmons pumps home that foul shot. That's 14 points tonight for Angela, who is Creighton's leading scorer at 14 points per game. Vicente to McMorris. Tiny McMorris was all alone on the baseline, not a hand in her face, and she rammed home her first field goal of the night. 3 points for Tiny. It's Chrissy Spanheimer being hounded by Jackie Stiles. Bounce pass underneath, and a fallaway jump shot does not go by Tracy Jones, but Jones does draw the foul, and we will have a parade to the foul line here as Tracy Jones will have a couple of shots.
Morgan Hohenberger right here along with her, and puts a little too much shoulder into her, and it'll be a two-shot foul, as you said.
75% free throw shooter is Tracy Jones, who has 5 points on the night, all of them coming here in the second half. 86-55 is the score as Janata Kadish comes in for SMS to replace Tiny McMorris. That's McMorris leaving the ballgame. She has three and gets congratulated by Coach Cheryl Burnett. Second shot for Tracy Jones. Under 5 minutes remaining in this game in Springfield, Missouri's Hammond Student Center. 86-55. The lead is Southwest Missouri State. Kadish underneath. That is a basket for Stephanie Busby on a great feed from Janata Kadish, and the timeout is called by Creighton. 88-55 is the score with 4:46 remaining.
Ned, Connie Yori is on her team, and I tell you what she's got to be worried about. They're losing continuity. They've got a season still to finish. They've got a weekend game. They've got to come back here for the tournament, and you can just tell they've lost their focus. She knows you've got to recapture that.
High point game for the year for the Lady Bears is 101, which they scored against one of the better teams in the country, the Iowa Hawkeyes. That was a game that we had here on KY3 back earlier this season, and the Lady Bears are threatening that right now with an 88-55 lead and still nearly 5 minutes remaining in this contest. Lady Bears will play Drake on Saturday afternoon at 2:15. That was 101-87 in that game back on December the 7th. And Jackie had 39 in that contest against the Iowa Hawkeyes. And now here is a turnover by Creighton. Angela Timmons is palming the ball. She turned it over in her hand. Angela can't believe the call. So the Lady Bears get it on the turnover with 4:42 remaining. Erica Vicente directing the attack, finds Jackie Stiles. Kadish underneath to Busby. Four quick points for the El Dorado Springs freshman, Stephanie Busby. Posted up is Teresa Wessling. She'll take the shot, And she'll get the roll. And Teresa Wessling with 6 points tonight, all six coming in the second half. And now we have Jackie Stiles going to the floor. And Jackie evidently is going to be charged with a foul. 4:11 remaining in this game in Springfield, Missouri. 90-57, Southwest Missouri State in the lead.
Chrissy Spanheimer draws that foul. They called it the other way.
So it'll be Jackie Stiles on the line for two. And Jackie looking to reach the 30-point mark tonight. That's the Lady Bears lead. Turnover, but the loose ball is picked up by Tracy Jones. Jones being guarded by Hohenberger. Pressure defense for the Lady Bears has really had Creighton completely out of sync. Good diving try by Morgan Hohenberger, the freshman for Southwest Missouri State, and we will take a timeout with 3:52 remaining in the game in Springfield, Missouri. All Southwest Missouri State, 92-57.
It's not just about saving money. It's about spending time, just dropping by, and creating bonds, rather than simply buying them. At Edward Jones, it's never just about investing. It's about knowing you and your dreams.
My every hope, my life, my world, it all begins with a dream.
Edward Jones, investing in you and your dreams.
Hi, folks. Jim Stafford here. Looking for something a little different? Up a little business.
You know, I used to be pro-choice, but with new medical advances, unborn babies are now being saved before birth with blood transfusions, even heart surgery. I'm confused. Why are some little ones, while still in the womb, treated with miracles, and other tiny babies of very same ages and perfectly healthy, aborted? Pro-choice just doesn't make sense to me anymore.
That's the damage, and it has been considerable at the Hammond Student Center. The SMS Lady Bears huge over Creighton, 92-57. This is a good Creighton team, Tom.
Well, just doing things so well, and this was the big moment about a half an hour, 45 minutes ago, when Jackie Stiles placed her name in the record books, moving to number one.
And the crowd in mass coming to its feet. Jackie has 30 points tonight. Tanya Senek into the paint. Doesn't get it to go, and the rebound pulled down by Busby, Stephanie Busby of the Lady Bears. The 30 points that Jackie has scored is her best ever against this Creighton team. Chrissy Spanheimer has been able to put good defense on Jackie during the past 4 years. Now Jackie turns it over, and this will be Tanya Senek. Good piece of dribbling by Tanya. Rather wild shot. Oh, a long shot, overshot by Candace Bloomquist, and the Lady Bears have it. Vicente to Jackie. And Jackie's shot doesn't draw iron either, goes out of bounds, and it was tipped, however, by Creighton, so the Lady Bears will get possession.
And I think Miss Stiles is done for the evening.
This will be Tiny McMorris coming in to replace Jackie Stiles. The fans sense it too that Jackie may have finished for the night. And another big round of applause, one of many for Jackie Stiles. Lady Bears inbound. That's Erica Vicente to trigger the attack. And the turnover. Coming up with the interception, Jenny Burns of Creighton. This is Finch. Little pass underneath, and the layup is scored, a virtual layup by Teresa Wessling. Excellent pass, too, by Danya Finch. Creighton has two players in double figures tonight, Angela Timmons and Christine Neneman. 92-59 is the score. The Lady Bears have a huge lead. This is McMorris. Under 3 minutes remaining. Danya Finch deep in the backcourt, now to Senek. That's Jimmy Burns with the ball in the right wing. Now into the post, and Westling misses the turnaround jump shot. The ball goes out of bounds, and possession will go to the Creighton Lady Jays. Now Hildebrand comes back in for Creighton, and it will be Candace Bloomquist to trigger the attack. Ball is knocked loose by the Lady Bears, but Danya Finch runs it down. Creighton has it, 23 seconds on the shot clock. Hildebrand could not execute on the play underneath, and here comes SMS. Under 2 minutes remaining. Lob pass underneath. It is Janata Kadish missing the shot, missing a chance to get in the scorebooks tonight. 94-59, all Lady Bears, and now Creighton, a lob pass is knocked loose by Tiny McMorris and out of bounds. Good defense by Tiny. 101 is the season high for the Lady Bears. They scored against Iowa back on December the 7th, 101-87 in a three-scoring game at the Hammond Student Center. It's a game in which Iowa had a fairly good-sized lead in the early going. The drive to the goal, the ball does not go. Jenny Burns missed it. The Lady Bears have their fast break going. Vicente to Hohenberger. Rebound is pulled down by Sarah Hildebrand, and the Creighton Lady Jays have it. This is Danya Finch. Rebound McMorris. Under a minute remaining in the game. There will be presentations made to Jackie Stiles at the conclusion of this contest. Morgan Hohenberger has her shoelaces untied. This pass goes out of bounds. Morgan, you need a timeout, and I think she's asking referee Lou Pitt for that timeout, and indeed she is. That's Morgan Hohenberger leasing up the sneakers as you look at Cheryl Burnett. 37 seconds remaining at the Hammond Student Center. This game long ago put out of reach. And the only mystery remained was to when Jackie Stiles would set the record, which she has since done. Shot is no good, taken by Candace Bloomquist, and the Lady Bears will apparently have the final shot of the game. 94-59 in favor of Southwest Missouri State as the Lady Bears get set to chalk up yet another victory. It will bring their record to 21-5 and 15-2 in the Missouri Valley Conference. And this contest will come to an end. It is the Lady Bears 94, Creighton 59. That is the final at Southwest Missouri State Hammond Student Center as a conglomeration of media and officials and players and coaches all gather out at center court for the pending celebration as Jackie Stiles has broken the national scoring record. Jackie with 30 points tonight. Creighton team leaving this court, and the Lady Bears come out at center court, as is their custom. Connie Urey and Cheryl Burnett shaking hands at the end of the game. 94-59, the Lady Bears come away with the victory tonight.
Spring's on the way, and so is March Madness. So to keep you going, Mrs. O'Mealy's will give you a choice. You can enjoy a complete chopped beefsteak or a chicken fried steak with mashed potatoes and gravy, corn or green beans, roll with butter, fruit cobbler or chocolate cake, and coffee or tea, all for only $5.99, a regular $8.15 value. Now through March 31st at Mrs. O'Mealy's on Sunshine just east of Bass Pro.
At Classic Wood Floors, we're serious about wood, and we have 45 years of experience to back it up. Come by Classic Wood Floors, and we'll show you all the beautiful woods to choose from. Rustic to exotic, in all colors and finishes, custom borders and patterns, or pre-finished flooring, all perfect for remodeling or new construction. Nothing else looks like wood, feels like wood, or lasts like real wood flooring. Classic Wood Floors,
523 West Plainview Road, Springfield's wood flooring experts.
Copy, print, scan, fax, and grow with the digital office equipment specialist, Copy Products Incorporated. Let Copy Products introduce you to today's fastest and most versatile digital office equipment on the leading edge of technology. You'll be amazed at what these machines can do for you. When you need a digital solution, call the digital specialist, Copy Products Incorporated, for all your office equipment needs.
It's back.
It's back.
The Ranger Roundup at Friendly Ford. Now you can lease a new Ranger Flare Size Super Cab 4x4 for only $199 per month for 24 months. You save $250 a month over a similar 48-month purchase. This Ranger 4x4 is loaded with options. Now you can drive it for only $199 per month, and we have 25 in stock. The $199 a month Ranger 4x4, now at Friendly Ford.
Back at the Hammond Student Center in Springfield, you're looking at the Lady of the Hour, Jackie Stiles, joined by assistant coach Karen Rapier. 3,133 career points, and now we join PA announcer Tony Lewis. I beg your pardon, this is Frank Dunn now handling the ceremony.
Basketball career scoring leader with 3,133 points from SMS, Miss Jackie Stiles.
Mom and Dad, Pat and Pam Stiles. Athletic Director Bill Rowe. And a massive banner.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to invite your attention to a brief ceremony commemorating this very, very special event. At this time, please welcome the president of SMSU, Dr. John Kaiser.
Jackie, any one of us here or in the national audience will rebound for you anytime. That's because you exemplify what we mean by the citizen student through maximum effort, teamwork, standards of excellence, family and community orientation, and gracious and caring behavior. Your 3.45 grade average makes it clear why both you and SMS are here. And those traits... Those traits are what the Templeton Foundation sees when it presents SMS awards for character and public affairs in your textbook. You have set a splendid record tonight, created memories none of us will forget. But while doing it, you have been supported by teammates of whom we are equally proud. Coaches, whom it's a privilege for me to call colleagues. And fan support that is the envy of the nation. Because we do not expect to see anyone with your talent and dedication in the near future, we want to thank you for sharing your game with us. So on behalf of the SMS community, nearly a century's worth, I want to congratulate and thank Jackie Stiles for making it a privilege to be a Bear and to present her with tonight's game ball.
That's the president of Southwest Missouri State, Dr. John Kaiser, presenting Jackie with the game ball, commemorative of her record-setting performance here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, also on hand to salute Jackie on this very special night, Missouri Valley Conference Commissioner Doug Elgin. SMS Director of Athletics,
Doug Elgin,
Mr. Bill
Commissioner
Rowe
of the Missouri Valley Conference, and Athletic Director Bill Rowe at Southwest Missouri State.
SMS Associate Director of Athletics, Dr. Darlene Bailey.
Dr. Darlene Bailey, giving
Lady Bears
a hug.
Head coach Cheryl Burnett.
And the head coach of the Lady Bears, Cheryl Burnett.
The previous Division I scoring record holder, Patricia Hoskins. And, of course, Jackie's mom and dad from Claflin, Kansas, Pat and Pam Stiles. Ladies and gentlemen, we're also very pleased to have some very special guests with us tonight to join in this occasion. First, 1973 SMS graduate and the 53rd governor of the state of Missouri, Governor Bob Holden. Mom gets the flowers. And here to present a resolution from the Missouri House of Representatives are two members of the Springfield Legislative Delegation, Representative Craig Hosmer and Representative B.J. Marsh.
These are State Representatives Craig Hosmer and B.J. Marsh with a special proclamation from the Missouri State Legislature.
And here from the City of Springfield to proclaim today, March 1, as Jackie Stiles Day in Springfield, is Mayor Lee Galloway.
Mayor Lee Ganaway of the City of Springfield, who proclaims today Jackie Stiles Day in Springfield, Missouri.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, before we conclude tonight's ceremony, we have one final announcement. Now, as you leave Hammond Student Center, each fan in attendance of tonight's game is going to receive a color autographed photo of Jackie Stiles to commemorate this special night. Now, we have one rule. You don't have to run to the exit because we have photos for everybody in Hammond Student Center, so we've got plenty. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to Jackie Stiles. Congratulations to the Lady Bears! And we will see you back there Saturday at 2:15 tonight from Hammond Student Center!
And the ceremonies have come to an end at the Hammond Student Center as Jackie Stiles establishes a new career scoring record in the NCAA Division I for women. 30 points tonight, breaking by 10 the mark previously held by Patricia Hoskins, who was on hand for the ceremonies. But over and above all of that, the Lady Bears come away with a massive victory over a pretty good Creighton team, folks, 94-59. And Tom asked, I think it's fair to say that Southwest Missouri State was focused on the task at hand tonight.
Well, they were, and the big key is how much did they use up that they might need Saturday against Drake, and I think everybody in the building is waiting for the outcome of the Drake-Wichita State game right now.
At last report, the Wichita State Lady Shockers, who can be awfully tough at home, were ahead of the Drake Bulldogs by 13 points, but that is in no way a final score.
The Lady Bears playing extremely well, and they will play Drake here at the Hammond Center on Saturday afternoon at 2:15 start, a game that you will see here on KY3.
Tell you what made things happen tonight. You brought it out so well early. Surprise performance by Erica Hante. Erica Vicente pulled the pressure off of Stiles and the teammates, and once they got the ball rolling, Stiles was able to step forward and put on her show.
Yeah, very good point, because Creighton was doing some shadowing, not exactly double-teaming Jackie, but the help defense was falling off and creating an opening in the Lady Bears' offense, and that opening was Erica Hante. Averaging only 4 points a game, she hit 14 in the first half, and that, as you mentioned, Tom, did alleviate some of the pressure on Jackie, and she proceeded to unload in that second half.
Well, she was waiting to get it all behind her, and once she did, everything happened. We're going to show it to you one more time in case you joined us a little late. Came very early in the second half, and Stiles was looking for an opening. She played into the paint and then kicked herself back out like this and got a nice feed. Thought about it, got a good look, and hit down a tray.
Yeah, the defender, Chrissy Spanheimer, pulled off just a little bit. Here it is coming up again, and you'll see Spanheimer dared her to shoot from three-point range. Pulled back, and Jackie unloaded, and there is the record-breaking goal. Cheryl Moran said, get back down court, forget that record.
I cannot imagine what they will do in practice. They'll prepare for Drake tomorrow, no question, but to review this game and find a lot of faults is going to be awful difficult for Coach Burnett and her staff.
Yeah, the Lady Bears shot a phenomenal percentage in this game. At one time, they were over 70%, and certainly they'll be in the high 60s in the final game statistics. Big victory for Southwest Missouri State in the final score of 94-59, all SMS in this one. Well, that sets the stage for Saturday's game, which will be tantamount to the Missouri Valley Conference regular season champion.
If Drake were to lose tonight, I tell you what, it's a heavyweight fight on Saturday afternoon against the two best teams over the last decade in the Missouri Valley Conference. If there were 91-55 here tonight, there may be 91-56 on Saturday.
There were only two losses on the schedule for the Lady Bears this year, two of them, one to Drake, and that was on New Year's Day, as a matter of fact, to get 2001 off to a very poor start, and to the University of Northern Iowa, and that game just last weekend, as a matter of fact, up in Cedar Falls, 2 weekends ago, I guess it was, up in Cedar Falls, Iowa. So the Lady Bears are anxious to avenge those two, and they get the chance against Drake, and that'll be coming up Saturday, 48 hours from now, a game that you will see right here on KY3, starting at 2:15. And the reason for the 2:15 start is because the Missouri Valley Conference Men's Tournament is going on up at the Savas Center, and with fingers crossed, we hope the Bears are playing in the Saturday noontime game. That would mean that they win tomorrow night. SMS is playing Wichita State tomorrow evening at 6 o'clock. If the Bears win it, they'll play at noontime on Saturday against Creighton, the top seed, and that game would be seen right here on KY3. So therefore, we've extended the starting time for the Lady Bears game to 2:15. And we certainly hope you join us right here on KY3 for all the action. So perhaps with fingers crossed, a doubleheader of Bears action here Saturday.
Yeah, you can bet a big bowl of popcorn, sit back, and enjoy it here. Tell you what, what's most impressive about the Lady Bears tonight is the way they put behind them the weak performance at Northern Iowa and the shaky effort at Wichita State. They came out and looked like a team fresh from preseason drills. They were all over the place this evening.
Especially impressive, the play in the post, because that level of play had taken some criticism here in recent weeks. But Jackie Stiles, of course, captures the headlines with the big shot. She had 30 points, and here is the three-pointer that established the new all-time scoring record. Jackie Stiles bombs away.
Brought them out of their seats.
Final score is 94-59. Southwest Missouri State, the winner over Creighton, and we hope you join us Saturday at 2:15 for the Lady Bears and Drake. We do thank you very much for joining us here on KY3. For my partner, Tom Mast, and our entire crew at KY3, I'm Ned Reynolds. We have ER coming up next, and then the KY3 Late Night Report. Thanks for joining us, everyone.